Hi guys, this is Joshi, and again I am here with you on Achieve IAS. As you know, हम लोग अभी at present in stream वो सारे topics ले रहे हैं जो कि हमारे exam के लिए important है. All those topics are covered on our channel that are important for your UPSC CSE 2020 or I can say any other government exam that you are going to appear in 2020. Okay. So today we are going to take a most important topic. We are going to take a most important topic today. So here you have to consider, you have to be alert about this topic, and you have to go through all the aspects of this topic, and you have to go through full video. I mean, you have to be here with me at the end of this video. Till end, we will discuss all about this system, all about this topic. Okay. So today we are going to discuss about police commissionerate system or police commissioner system, what it is. So you know very well that why it is in news, and this is the first ever system that has been introduced in our country recently in just two cities only. So it is the most important for our examination. So let's have a look towards it. So here, why we are discussing it? Recently, the UP government has approved implementation of police commissionerate system in just two cities of it. Which one? Lucknow and Noida. Here it is the point that you have to note or you have to learn that here only two cities that have implemented the police commissionerate system, and these two cities are Lucknow and Noida. And why it is enforced or why we implemented this system? So the reason behind this, since the past 50 years there was a demand to enforce the police commissionerate system. Okay, in 1978 an initiative to introduce commissionerate system in Kanpur never materialized. Yeah, it was the initiative, but it didn't work at that time. Okay, so the commissionerate system will give police a free hand to act swiftly and take decisions regarding, you know, where sometimes we see that police says, or we can feel that police is bounded somewhere. Police system is not in the condition where they can take the swift action or the you know, the instant actions about any particular situation or any particular you know, crime or something else. But now in this system, the police commissionerate system, police is free-handed. I mean, police commissionerate system will give police a free hand to act swiftly, and they can take decisions regarding maintaining law or an order in the complex urban milieu. Now, powers of a district magistrate, I mean DM, under 15 acts lie with the police. So here the powers of all these district magistrates held with the police will have the equivalent power to the district magistrates. Okay, so let's go through the next historical background of it. Policing is based on the Police Act of 1861. Under the colonies, it is based on dual system of police administration. Okay. Now the overall in charge of the district of region was the district collector, and the superintendent of police, it means SP, reported to him. Okay, the head is district collector, and the reporting person is superintendent of police, it means SP. Now the primary objective of the British was revenue collection in rural area. At that time this police system was created for an objective, and what was the primary objective of it? The primary objective of Britishers was to revenue collection in rural areas. For that they appointed the police. Okay, they needed a force that could support this objective and unleash tyranny and oppressions when needed to suit the objective. Okay, they want some police force or some forces, the first bunch of peoples that will work on their points, tip points, and then they no one can oppose them. Okay, that's why they created a system of police or commissionerate system, something like that. Okay, and after that, the reason behind this, that was revenue collection. The British also brought the police commissionerate system first in Kolkata. The first introduction of police commissionerate system was in Kolkata, एंड आफ्टर दैट मुंबई एंड चेन्नई प्रेजिडेंसीज. द सिस्टम वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस्ड इवन बिफोर द पुलिस एक्ट ऑफ 1861. द कमिश्नरेट सिस्टम इज कंसिडर्ड अ स्टेप टूवर्ड्स पुलिस रिफॉर्म्स एंड डायरेक्शंस ऑफ द सुप्रीम कोर्ट इन प्रकाश सिंह वर्सेज यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया. सो हेयर वॉट इट इज, आई मीन प्रकाश सिंह वर्सेज यूनियन ऑफ इंडिया वॉज पर्टिकुलर यू नो सेशन वेयर द और आई कैन सी एन आर्ग्यूमेंट एंड वी विल डिस्कस इट इन फॉलोइंग यू नो नेक्स्ट वीडियोज और समथिंग नेक्स्ट सेशंस. सो इन 1996 अ पिटिशन वॉज फाइल्ड बिफोर द सुप्रीम कोर्ट दैट रेज वेरियस इंस्टेंस ऑफ अब्यूज ऑफ पावर बाय द पुलिस एंड एलेक्ट बाय पुलिस पर्सनल परफॉर्म देयर ड्यूटीज इन द पॉलिटिकली पार्टिसन मैनर. यू नो वेरी वेल दैट टूडे in India the most of the impacts have been seen of political politicians only, and political features are you can see the political features in all the areas of our country, and we can see the impact of politicians in all the areas of country. So so many times you have heard about that police is involved in this political matter or that political matter, this is a political matter, this crime is in this crime the person or the prisoner didn't get any type of you know for that because of political support, or we can say this was done because of political pressure. So all these things, all these issues can be drained out because of this system or with the support of this system. Now how it will work and how it will be useful or it will be useful or not, we don't know. But still we can say that this system will help it in lot. Okay, the Supreme Court issued its judgment in 2006 ordering the center and states to set up authorities to lay down guidelines of police functioning, okay, evaluate police performance and decide posting and transfers and receive complaints of police misconduct. Okay, now if police is doing misconductions or something like posting, if they are doing honestly and they get the postings or transfers or something else, then the authorities will take up the steps about it. Now the courts also required that minimum tenure of service be guaranteed to key police officers to protect them from arbitrary transfers and postings. We know very well that if a person will be honest, if a police commissioner or police SP or DSP or something will be honest, then they will definitely get the transfers because political impact, because of politicians impacts and political impacts. So to protect all these police officers or police forces from these political impacts, it is a good system to introduce. Okay, now Delhi turned into a commissionerate during 1977 to 1979. Yeah, okay, Delhi is in commissionerate system and it was commissionerate between 1977 to 1979. National Police Commission's 6th report released in 1983 recommended the police commissionerate system in cities. Yeah, it was recommended in the report of National Police Commission. It was the 6th report that was released by 1983. Okay, with the population of 5 lakh and above, as well as in places having special conditions, were recommended this system. Okay, this system was recommended that the population or the place where the population of 5 lakh and above is living, and the place where these conditions are, special conditions are having, then there should be the commissionerate system. It was introduced or recommended by the National Police Commissioners Commission's 6th report that was released in the 1983. Sorry. So in 2005, Draft Model Police Act, framed by a committee set up by the Home Minister, also made a similar recommendations, saying metro cities and major urban areas with a population of 10 lakh or more should have commissionerate system. Okay, so we can see there were so many times when commissionerate system was recommended or it was said that it should be implemented or something else, but we didn't accept it. Now it is the time when we are going to accept it. Okay, As of January 2018, the system has been implemented in 61 cities across 15 states of the country, okay, according to BPRD data 2018. However, after UP, 63 cities now have this system. So, what is the expert bodies that have examined police reforms? Let's have a look. It is National Police Commission, that was in 1977 to 81. Ribeiro Committee, that is in 1998. And Padmanabhai Committee, that is in 2000. And Mallinath Committee, that is in 2002 to 2003. Police Act Drafting Committee, 2005. Supreme Court Directions in Prakash Singh versus Union of India, 2006. Second Administrative Reforms Commission, that is in 2007. And Police Act Drafting Committee, that was in 2015. So these were the expert bodies that have examined the police reforms. Okay. Now let's have a look towards the constitutional or legal provisions. So according to this, there are some officer rank persons. Then here are some upper subordinates of 13% and lower subordinates of 86%. So you can see here the officers ranks is 1%. What it is, the DGP, additional DGP, IGP, deputy IGP, superintendent of police, SP additional, we can say, and additional SP upper than the superintendent of police senior, there will be the senior, then the superintendent of police SP, and then additional SP, okay, then assistant deputy SP. Here these all cadres were divided into heads of the state police force, heads zone and heads range, heads larger police districts and heads police districts. And here assistant deputy SP is and comes under the heads of subdivision. Okay, now upper subordinates, these are 13%, that are inspector, sub-inspector, assistant. There are three categories that are included in upper subordinates. Okay, so these are included in heads police stations in urban areas and head police stations in rural areas. And under these, it have some head constables and constables that are of 86%. Okay, this is the provision for, we can say, constitutional or legal provisions. Okay, this is the police system, police commissioner system, and these according to legal provisions only. Okay, so under the 7th schedule of the constitution, police is under the state list. You know very well there are three lists: state, concurrent and union. So in 7th schedule of the constitution, police comes under the state list. Political executive, that is ministers, has the power of superintendent and control over the police forces to ensure their accountability. The center is also allowed to maintain its own police forces to assist the states with ensuring law and order. Therefore, it maintains 7 central police forces and some other police organizations for specialized tasks such as intelligence gathering, investigation, research and record keeping and training. Okay, the center is responsible for policing of the union territories. It also extends intelligence and financial support to the state police forces. State police forces generally have 2 arms, that is civil and armed police. Okay, the civil police are responsible for day-to-day law and orders and crime control. So here it is important that police that is responsible for day-to-day law and orders and crime control comes under the civil police. And what are armed police? The armed police are kept in reserve until additional support is required in situation like riots. Okay, so civil police forces broadly adhere to the hierarchical structure shown in the figure. So here it is mentioned in statement format. So the first thing is dual system. The state government exercises control and superintendent over the state police forces At the district level, the district magistrate also give directions to the superintendent of police and supervise police administration. The power such as issuing orders or for preventing arrest and imposition of section 144 are vested in the DM. This was under the dual system. Okay, now let's go through the commissionerate system, what it is. There are two systems, that is dual system and commissionerate system. In commissionerate system, some metropolitan cities and urban areas, whereas the dual system has been replaced by the commissionerate system to allow for quicker decision making in response to complex law and order situations, rising population and rapid urbanization. The police have a greater say in involving land disputes. However, removal or encroachments and other land related problems would not need to be need the presence of a magistrate to aid the police. Okay. So what is the basic difference between the dual system of control or the commissioner system? So here it is dual system and commissioner system. You can see here there is some major differences that in dual system, police is just for controlling system, and the police vest with the SPs and district magistrates. And in commissioner system, here the structure with the unified command structure with the commissioner of police as the sole head of force within the city, okay, allows the quicker response to law and order situations. Is under this dual system, separation of powers of the DM and the police, okay. And the under commissioner system, it is magistracy concentrated in commissioner, powers of policing and magistracy, and directly accountable to the state government and state police chief, okay. And in this, less concentration of powers in police, but here it is lesser accountability of the local administration. Here local administration is powerful in dual system, but local administration is less accountable in commissionerate system, okay. SP is assisted by the additional assistant deputy SP and inspectors and constabulary, but in commissionerate system, commissioner is assisted by the special joint additional deputy commissioners, etc., inspector downwards rank structure in the same, okay. So here why we need the commissionerate system. Commissionerate system is considered the most authoritative system of policing, not only in other progressive countries but also in states of the countries. The system brings greater power and responsibilities. It is considered essential in cities with the larger population. Now suggestions are being made that it should be implemented at least in the city with the population of 20 lakhs. Big cities generally through law and other order problems and other problems which students agitations and caste communal problems, labor agitations related to law passed by the government, okay. This requires very specialized handling and requires, yeah, these are the sensitive matters. So on these matters, it is required to take the handling or coordinating steps. So for that, there can be a difference of opinion between officials, okay. Hence these we can say multifarious complicated issues needs unity of command. In the present case of UP, Noida shares borders with the national capital, which already has a commissionerate system. After the implementation of the commissionerate system in UP, there would be better coordination in policing, okay. Moreover, in Mumbai, the system has been proved successful in handling complex issues of Mumbai, which also had faced the problem of the underworld, okay. Even in the commissionerate system, unfettered power is not given to the police. Police are answerable to ministers and courts. So here we don't need to be scared that police will do this and that and all those that are getting like what is there in their mind, they can implement that and something like that. No, here police is answerable. He is responsible to answer the ministers and courts, and they will decide that how much the power should be given, okay. Now, what are the concern of this matter? The concern is legacy issue, delegation of authority, immense powers, scared of the police, failed to win public confidence. Yeah, here it is. All these are the very sensitive issues. We after listening the commissionerate system, the first thing that comes in the mind, or even listening the word police, the most of the public is just like scaring, getting scared. Or some legacy issues, delegation of authority. Here it is also a thing that police is somewhere, somehow it is good in delegation of authorities, and it will use the immense powers of it, and the police will, people will generally get scared of police, and they will, polices generally fail to win the public confidence, okay, and the trust the civil administrative officials and feel more comfortable in interacting with them because they create balance in society, okay. And other than this, further, there are several occasions when protests are of the civil nature and can be dealt with the district magistrate. Police action in such matters can complicate the situation. Here, police matters are just like the, it is just like, you know, complicating the situations. Here, there are so many matters in a society that are dealt with district magistrates only. Okay, this system works better in states where the literacy ratio is higher and people have wide knowledge about law and their fundamental rights. So what are the way forwards, what will the what will be the consequences, and what we are going to see about it, and what we are going to face in this system. The commissionerate system brings great power to the commissioner of police. Hence, it calls upon a degree of restraint in using powers. In this, the selection of commissioner becomes crucial. An officer who has a wider knowledge of handling crime investigation in the complex urban-centric milieu and has the capacity to both restrain and increase powers will do well. Okay. Now, as it is rightly said that with great power comes great responsibilities. If police will get the great powers, they will definitely get the great responsibilities, and they have to fulfill all those responsibilities. And better detection of crime, it will be the better that the criminalization will be lower, and the rate of criminalization will be on just, you know, bottom of this situation, and police will handle it, so it will be better in law conditions, okay, and better quality of investigations will be done, increased conviction rate and decline of crime rate, okay. Police system suffers a series of deficiencies from problems relating to the police organizations, environment, infrastructure and understaffing, to absolute weaponry and intelligence gathering techniques, to a shortage of manpower, of corruption. The police force in the country is not in good shape. Okay, therefore, there is an urgent need for holistic police reform. Since police law and orders are subjects to state list, the government can start by urging all states to implement the recommendations given by the Supreme Court in Prakash Singh case. Okay, and to understand this case as much better, you should go for the Prakash Singh case, and here I will try to make video on it also. So hope you get all about commissionerate system and what are the reasons behind this, what are the historical background, what it is and how it will be implemented, and what are the reforms, police reforms, expert bodies, legal provisions, and we have also discussed about the dual system, commissionerate system, and the difference between all these systems, and the most important thing, what, why we need it, what is the need of commissionerate system, why we suddenly gone through all these systems, or why we suddenly just choosing this system, like commissionerate system, okay. And what are the concerns of it, what are the way forwards, and what we are going to think about it, and what we are going to expect with the system. So we have discussed all these things in this particular video, and hope you all got it, and it will be helpful for you, and best of luck for your exam.